actually starting to change right now. I want to show you the Storm Prediction Center outlook for the rest of the day. We do have the marginal risk. That means that we have a chance for an isolated severe thunderstorm. And then in yellow, we have the slight, which means that we have one or two. The main players here being winds and hail. Now let's go to day two. We're just looking at thunder, so it's a lot better. We're still not out of the weeds with the rain, though. Let's take a look at Skywatch 7. It is gray as those clouds filter in. Going to be a warm day. Those temperatures in the upper 60s. The temperature contrast, I'll show you what that looks like in those temperatures. It's in the 60s as you're near Lake Ontario, but we're seeing the same thing as we saw yesterday. Warmer in the 70s for the southern tier and Pennsylvania. Now, in first weather, I showed you that it was a bit gusty. It's breezy as well. Around the lake, you're seeing anywhere between 15 and almost 20 miles an hour in your sustained wind speeds. In this bubble here, not reporting a wind speed in the yellow, but we can definitely see that those sustained wind speeds are quite gusty over there as well. Now let's take a look at the temperatures. I want to widen the view out because temperatures are on the move. If you don't like these temperatures this warm, they are going to tumble as we head into the end of the work week. Keeping that wide view, you're seeing all that lightning with associated low pressure system and its front making its way over towards us. Let me zoom things in to show you. We're seeing some light showers starting to develop right along the Chautauqua Ridge there and into downtown. But like I said, in first weather, probably not hitting the ground yet, seeing it as Virga, and we saw evidence on that when we looked at Skywatch. However, we will be seeing some more of those showers, and they will be reaching us. Let me show you what it looks like in our future cast. So by the evening, you're seeing those showers making their way through the southern tier, and you see those reds and the oranges blooming there, some of those heavier showers, especially for the New York Pennsylvania line, seeing some of those areas with those heavy downpours, gusty winds, and possibility for hail. As you head into the overnight, we'll see some more rain. We'll deal with more rain as you go into tomorrow, starting off the morning with rain. It is going to be a washout for your tomorrow. We have more moderate to steady rainfall in the yellows and oranges, possibly some more thunder as well. And as we head into the evening, seeing some more rain showers. Check out what happens as we go into Friday morning. You're seeing a little bit of wintry mix around Jamestown. Those temperatures, I'll show you what everything looks like in the 7-day temperature-wise, because it's not going to stick around. But today we've got some more scattered showers. We'll call them hit or miss showers because it's not widespread showers. Some of these will be strong to severe with those temperatures in the 60s if you're near Lake Ontario. However, if you head towards the southern tier of Pennsylvania, seeing those temperatures in the 70s. For the overnight, we still got some of those thunderstorms to get through early with those temperatures in the 40s. Going into the rest of the 7-day, your tomorrow, we are going to see some rain with the potential for some thunder there. Those temperatures tumbling a little bit into the 50s. They're on the move though into Friday, cooler with those showers. Temperatures only seeing the 40s. 30s overnight Friday into Saturday with the temperatures in the 50s. And look at how we go back into the 60s for the second half of the weekend and to the end of the 7-day, rounding it off in the 50s.